What's up, everybody? Today is Monday, June the 15th. We are bringing you Nino, Luey. Episode 39 is going down with my man, the video director. It's a new kind of guest, actually. So he'll explain a lot about his career, like how and why it started. He'll explain like the struggles behind it, I guess. Pretty much that sums it up, but I don't want to give away too much of the interview. But it'll be good. We talk about some interesting things. Excuse me. And I hope you guys enjoy it as much as I did. But before we get into that, let's talk about some UFC fights this weekend. So, four performance of the night bonuses, I guess. Marvin Vittori, I believe, got one. A girl from Kazakhstan got one. There's a couple handed out. So, there's four of the night. I think it was like two submissions and two TKOs. But the way the night started off, it was like all the first three fights, I believe it was, were like under the first minute of the fight, which I found was very weird. It was like the matches weren't really even, but I guess that's the fight game. You can never really expect what's coming. But yeah, so I like the fights. If you guys want to let me know what you think, slide into those DMs. I'm always there talking to my fans, so feel free to message me. But I'm looking forward to June 20th. There's some good ones on there. My man Josh Emmett is in the co-main event. That'll be a scrap for the year. Possible fight of the night. Opportunity there. Maybe even fight of the year or fight of the month. However that goes, I hope it goes well. There's some other fights going on there. But this weekend, we also saw Charles Jourdain versus Touchy Feely, Andre Feely. I like that one as well, and I believe that should have been like a fight of the night, I guess. I don't know if they were handing that out or what, but I like that one too. I believe that was kind of a back and forth, Feely getting knocked down in the first round and coming back, kind of exposed Jourdain and his weakness by taking him down a lot. But I believe that was a good one. That was probably my favorite one of the night, if I'm being honest there. But let's get into this episode with Mr. Nino Luey. Hope you guys enjoy it. Let me know what you think. Comment, subscribe, like the video, and we'll be seeing you at the end of this video. Mr. Video Director Nino Luey, how's it going today, my friends?
I'm doing good. Just seeing how this whole COVID thing will play out, you know? I'm trying to get back to work, back to regular schedule, you know? Just seeing how it goes.
For sure. So how have you, or what have you been up to during this downtime, kind of editing your videos and whatnot?
That's
editing
it. Video, Call of Duty,
oh yeah.
Warzone,
there you go.
You know, eating like a savage.
You know, oh boy.
You know, like everybody else, just stuck at home trying to make the most of it.
For sure. So since the beginning, how long has it been since you've been producing videos and editing them for your clients?
About 9 years.
All right, so it's been about a while then.
Years. It's been a while. It's been a long time.
For sure. So we talked about you editing videos, but what do you find harder, editing the videos or shooting them, actually?
Editing.
Really? It takes a lot of work, actually.
Like, shooting's the fun part. Shooting's like, you're in the vibes, people are having fun, you know, and then editing's like, you're alone, and it's boring, and like, you know, you try, like, sometimes you just make the most of it. It depends on the video too, right? Like, not every song's a hit, not every song is exciting to work on, you know, but it's a job still sometimes. Sometimes it doesn't feel like a job, sometimes it feels like I dread it, you know? know?
Yeah.
So,
All right, so we lost you there for a little bit. Hopefully, we didn't miss anything too good, but.
Oh no no! I was saying that not every song's a hit, so it's not always fun to edit, right?
Yeah, like, yeah.
Maybe shooting the video is fun, but sometimes editing can just be dreadful because like life gets busy, and sometimes you gotta go home and there's more work to be done.
Yeah,
you just wanna
yeah.
lay down. You know what I mean? Like, sometimes it sucks.
So, like you said, it depends on who you're shooting, but throughout your career, who's been, like, the most fun to shoot for, I guess?
Well, I think Pressa. Pressa was fun because we did, like, 8 videos.
Oh, really?
And the momentum, like, off every video was just exciting, like, seeing the levels, like, upping, how do I say this, like, just up in the level every time we dropped the video and seeing like the response, that was exciting. And then my other one would be Roadrunner.
Okay.
Just because like those two artists, I started them from like the very beginning, and they got somewhere. Same with like other ones, but I didn't shoot as much with the other artists. So to me, like my exciting artist was Pressa and Roadrunner. And then Kid was cool because I grew up on G Unit.
Really? Okay.
Kid was cool.
So you guys were like close growing up, I guess.
Huh?
You guys were like close growing up, I guess?
No. I'm saying I grew up on G Unit. Like
yeah.
I grew up on 50 Cent's music.
Oh, okay.
Kid's part of G Unit. So
yeah.
When I got to
That's
work
awesome.
With him, it was pretty cool.
For sure. So you shot many videos, but you gotta tell us what has been a tough moment behind the scenes that us people like me don't. I broke out. Can you hear me alright?
Hold on. I can hear you, just let it like.
Let
like
it settle.
Trying to catch up or something.
Alright.
I'll tell you when.
Maybe I'm talking too fast.
I don't know, no, I think it's like the connection. I don't know if it's me or. I don't know, maybe my internet.
Half and half.
What were you saying?
I said half and half, maybe it's both of ours.
Yeah, but like, what was your question?
Alright, so I was saying, you shot many videos in your career, but there had to be at least one tough moment behind the scenes that people like me don't actually get to see.
Like a tough moment? Like, what do you mean? Like, something that stood out that didn't go great?
Yeah, or? Yeah, I guess you could say that. Yeah.
There's been times where I think this probably has happened only twice.
Okay.
But there's the worst part is like having to do a whole video shoot. Like you do a whole video shoot. It happened. I did a whole video shoot. It was nice. We went on like rooftops, this and that. And then on the way home, when I put the chip into the computer, there was no
it's
footage.
Deleted. Oh, really?
So like I know that it was there, but somehow it just disappeared.
Jeez.
So it sucks. It's like little things like that. Like people don't know. Like things like that happen. There's just no way to fix it unless you just go back and shoot it all over
yeah,
again.
Yeah.
So like those are things that suck. Like
yeah.
really suck.
Has there been a time where you like accidentally deleted a video and you couldn't like add that in
no.
the clip? No?
Because I set back everything up.
Okay.
I back everything. So as soon as I have the chip, I bring it home and I'll put it onto a hard drive and just make sure I have a backup of it.
So currently in the world there's been I feel there's not as much recognition for the people like you, I guess we could say, like the video producers and whatnot. Do you believe they should get more recognition for what they do?
I think so. I believe so. Because we're like the stepping stone. We bridge the gap from your music to visuals, right? Just like how producers are well known because they're making the beats.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? So
yeah.
I feel like, yeah. We don't get the recognition we deserve because we're putting out, like, we put out a lot of videos.
Yeah.
And consistently, and, you know what I mean? Like, it picks up ground for you. It picks up momentum for your music. So it's, like, it's good if you can just show a little love to the video shooters because, like, we make a lot of happen. Sometimes, like, videos don't go as planned. And when you edit them, that's where the magic happens. That's, like, fuck, can you pull it off? And
yeah.
Sometimes I've been able to pull off shit that just I thought was gonna be a whack video, and it turns out to get like million views, you know, so it's like...
Becomes a hit.
We deserve a little more recognition, yes.
Mm-hmm. So you mainly produce rap, I guess. Why is rap different from pop or country, I guess, you could say?
Well, the thing is, like, I don't know. I'm in the world of hip-hop. I love hip-hop. And there's a lot of rappers. I don't know any pop singers. I don't know any R&B. Like, I know a few R&B singers.
Can't forget T-Swift.
You know, they just don't reach out to us because I guess we do hip-hop, right? If someone was like, oh, can you do a rock video? I'd be down.
Yeah.
I'd get more rock clients, you know? But as far as the world knows, Nino's a music video producer for the hip-hop artists in Toronto.
For sure. For sure. So, what should people know before they become in your position, like a video director and whatnot?
What should people know?
Yeah, like let's say they want to be a producer of their own. What should they know before they do that?
Make sure you want to do it because it's hours. Like it's not something you're just gonna pick up and it's not like it's different.
Yeah,
like, you have to dedicate. You really have to. You have to make sure this is what you want to do. You have to be motivated, inspired, ambitious, because it's not like going to work. You're gonna be like, well, I gotta do this, you know? It's like someone's putting their music, their visuals, their hopes and dreams in your hands, you know?
So
like you just gotta actually want it. You gotta want to do it, because you're gonna be spending hours on YouTube. How do you do this on this editing software? How to put your settings to it? And it's gonna take a lot of time going outside shooting and just doing a lot of free work to perfect your craft, you know. So you just gotta want it. Make sure that if you're gonna pick up a camera, like you want it, because it's not cheap. You're gonna have to upgrade every once in a while. It's not cheap, you know. But just make sure that you want to do it before you just decide, oh, I'm gonna be a cameraman. Like, no, you gotta want to act your camera.
Yeah, so I was just gonna ask you that. What's like the most expensive, or what are the expenses for the equipment you actually use for your videos?
So the camera alone is like $5,000, right? And then my laptop's another $4,000. The monitor I use to see what I'm doing is another $2,200. Then you got your softwares, your plugins, you have the Ronin, the stabilizer. That already, you're probably looking at $15,000 to $20,000 in investments, right?
So it is a lot.
I mean, like, it's not cheap, but you can, that's like, if you're a starter, you don't gotta worry about that.
Yeah,
just get
your
first little Canon T5i, which is like $700. Just make sure you have a decent laptop. You can start shooting, and then once you start shooting, you make some money. This is where you start reinvesting into a new camera.
Of course, you know?
Like, if you want it, you'll get there, you know? Like, fuck, all the shit that I got doesn't just appear, you know?
Yeah.
You have to work for it.
Of course. So with that, all that gear, what does the next project look like for you?
Well, this year I was hoping I would be able to work my ass off even harder, but with this whole COVID shit, I can't book studio.
Yeah.
I can't book places that help me elevate my game. So once this is over, I'm gonna start going more into more professional work. So being working at a studio, like video studio, where just control lighting, props in, and just do a lot more traveling to just make sure the visuals are crisp. So I'm pleading for a Roadrunner to come out of jail. So he can get back to work, because he's like my number one artist right now. Like, he comes back and very excited to work with him. And then I have QP. Not a lot of people are familiar for her music yet, because she's working hard, but she has a look to her. Everybody's paying attention in this city. Everybody knows who she is, because I bring her around a lot, and she does her own thing, so people notice her. But ever since I started bringing her to the video shoots, a lot of people are like, yo, who is that? So I'm excited to see where QP's growth goes. But as far as work, those are the two people that I'm really excited to work with and see where it goes.
So I want to ask you, what is like the process of, like, it's like raising a newborn kid, I guess, like starting from the very bottom and elevating their game, I guess, to the top. What goes on behind the scenes, and like, what's the hustle behind that?
well, I'm only like one part of it, right? Like, without the artist making their music, I can't do nothing, right?
Until
they're done. So, for my behind the scenes, it's like, it's really just nothing, really. Like, I just gotta wait for the artist to finish their song and then hit it up. And then, you know, we've got to plan things, see if we need a car, we gotta go rent a car, we need models that have models, girls come. If, you know, it's just, it's very simple, you know, nothing too complicated, but. I mean, if it requires a lot more, then we'll do that and just put it all together, but it's really not that complicated.
Really? Okay, so talking about models, I'll have to get in one of those shoots one time.
Sorry?
I said talking about models, I'll have to get into one of those shoots one time, I don't know.
Yeah. You can come to, it's fun, like I said, that's where the fun's at, because people are drinking, smoking, chilling, the vibe's there. Sometimes these girls are just like, they're fun, you know?
No, I might be wrong on this one, but it looks like you're wearing some kind of jersey. I don't know.
I'm just wearing a Chicago Bulls jersey.
Oh,
just,
come on. Yeah. You gotta represent the Raptors.
Yeah, I'll grab my next Raptors jersey.
Alright. Perfect. Are you actually a Raptors fan at all?
Oh, yeah. I was really proud of them. I was really happy with their championship win.
Yeah, so this one, I'm not a magician or anything, but I got to imagine it's got to say Jordan on the back of that Bulls jersey.
I'm not, bro. It's just
just Bulls?
Jersey, no names on it.
All right, I told you.
Jordan was my favorite player, too.
Okay, fair enough. So back to the topic. We got off topic there, my bad. But all right, so you got to give me your top three rappers. Like, you can't include the ones you've already shot for, but like, who are your top three rappers that, like, maybe one day you would like to shoot for?
Before this nigga turned into a snitch, I was really excited to see what it would be like.
For 6ix9ine.
Like, 6ix9ine was so entertaining. He was just so entertaining. Like, I wonder if I'd ever get to meet him or just say what's up at least, but...
So that's one, 6ix9ine.
I've always wanted to, like, if I could, if I was doing this back in the 90s, I would have loved to work with Tupac. Like, Tupac's my favorite. Like, he was just real. Like, I feel like I could have had, like, some crazy conversations with him.
Yeah.
Right now in the game, like, who would, fuck, that's tough. I haven't thought about it.
Threw you off guard there.
In Toronto, I pretty much worked with everybody.
Even Drake?
In the States? Yeah, I would love to work with Drake, but I'm not there yet.
Okay.
I would love to work with Drake. I would love to work... Who's my other favorite rapper? There's a few I've been listening to. I just can't think of it right now.
No, like Kanye or Lil Wayne?
No. I love them all, but they've done their thing so well. Like, my thing is starting with buddy.
Okay, yeah.
My thing is, like, being able to find somebody and grow with them and make them go. Because it's like working with someone that's already successful, they have it all. There's no climax. There's no, like, you're going up with them, you know? It's just like...
They're already there, so...
It'll do a lot of great for me, of course. It'll be like, oh, he shot for so-and-so.
Yeah.
But I'd rather be the guy that just... I find somebody, I'm like, oh, this kid's talented, let's shoot him a video. And then what I expected to happen happened. That's where I get my joy. That's where I live for.
Okay.
So it's hard to say who I would like, who's out there that I'd want to work with. It's hard to say.
Alright, so last one I got for you before I let you go here. What are your thoughts on the passing of some of these young and up and coming rappers? Like, what should we be doing to prevent that from happening?
It's so deeply rooted, bro. It's like, it sucks, it's sad, because, like, I was a fan, I've met some of these, I've been friends with them, like, I've talked with them, I've had conversations with them, and then when you find out they got shot, it sucks, it's like, fuck, like, you know they were, they were destined for greatness.
Yeah.
And for it to stop, it's like, it's just so deeply rooted, it's like, these guys are out here, these guys are in the streets, so it's like, just imagine my brother gets shot, you know, and he gets killed, like... The revenge. revenge and hate inside of these people. It's like something that nobody can just come and be like, talk to them and tell them to change their mind, because they just they're in pain. So it's like it's hard for it to stop. It's just, or else it would have stopped already.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? If it was easy for it to stop, it would just stop. No one would be dying. So it's hard. It's hard to say. What can we do to stop it? It's beyond. It's
really
me.
Nothing.
It's beyond the people.
All right. So I want to give you the opportunity to thank anyone you feel is necessary. The floor is all yours, Nino.
Thank anyone. I don't know what to thank. I thank myself, because I call myself. You know what I mean? Like,
I see.
Thank me, bro, cause I'm the one doing it. You know, no one gave me a camera. No one gave me a computer. No one said, like, you'll do this. Thank me, bro.
There you go.
Thank myself.
All right. Awesome. So it was a fun time.
I appreciate it. Talking to me, talking to you, and put this out, you know, get a little shine, some little in-depth to what's going on behind the scenes.
Of course. So I never actually asked you, like, personally, I know who you've like shot for, but I don't know if the people really know, like, the big names you've shot for. So go ahead and tell us I know you've shot for Tory and all, but who else is there?
Big, like, up and coming names?
Yeah.
Names. It's,
like the up and comers, I guess.
I've shot for, and I was a big fan of him, like, for years before I even met him, so it was a good feeling. Like, I felt like I belong in this, like, I'm doing the right thing, this is me.
Yeah.
Like I said, Pressa is pretty well known now, so I shot for Pressa, shot for Northside Benji, I shot for Chromaz. I've shot for 3M French. I've shot for Roadrunner. I've shot for Young Tory. Who would be a familiar name to say? I've shot for Burn Up Bands. Houdini was there. Killer the Crook was in the video. Who else? I think those are the bigger names.
Okay. Yeah,
it's
awesome.
Like, I'm missing somebody, but those are the bigger names.
All right, so if you think of it, just let me know and I'll add that in there.
Okay, no problem.
Yeah.
I think that's
pretty much
there's
it.
Obviously, like, a bunch of other, like, rappers, but well-known names, those are the guys.
Yeah, it's awesome. So, like I said, we went a little over. I said we were going to leave you, but it was awesome having you on. So, hopefully we'll be catching up soon.
Sorry?
I said hopefully we'll be catching up soon.
Yeah, for sure, brother. Thanks for calling.
All right.
Gotcha.
Take care.
Brother, take care.
See ya.